Okay, hello everyone. My name is Adenike Adebola. Welcome to my first episode, the first episode of my renewable energy podcast. So in this episode, I'm going to be talking about how do I say it? It's going to be an introduction. Why did I decide to do this podcast? What are we expecting? So why did I decide? I decided to set to start off on this podcast because I've been doing a lot of reading on the energy transition, renewable energy. What can I do both in my personal life and my professional life to help the world ensure that we don't go extinct based on the alleged issues related to climate change and how the energy we deploy can help us save us from ourselves. So basically, that's it. I'm actually a technical safety engineer, so I work in the energy industry already. Currently, oil and gas, but I hope to expand my reach to every part of the energy space, including renewable energy. So I'm going to pause. Okay, so I'm back. Thanks for staying with me. Why I already said. So what am I going to be sharing? I'm going to be sharing about how I, as an individual, in my personal life, what I'm doing to help halt the race to, would I say, Armageddon as a person, what you can practically do to help us save our planet, they would say. And I'll also share what I'm learning professionally. And it kind of reminds me of a conversation I had with one of my siblings, my brother. And he was like, "Come, auntie, come. Why are you packing? Why are you taking course upon course upon course?" He's like, "You have plenty of money." And I was like, "No, I really want to understand the issues so that I know where I can play. I know where my strength is." And so I've taken a few courses in renewable energy. I've been doing a lot of reading. Thankfully, in my workplace, there's a community that I've joined where I'm learning more. I've signed up to become a sustainability champion because I want to really, really do something. I know there are a lot of people that believe that, oh, it's all a scam, it's all from the liberal left. And I wish I could say that it's a total lie, but I believe there's a bit of propaganda involved here. But I believe there's an issue that needs to be addressed anyway. We've seen physical evidences of climate change, so I don't think it should be ignored, but I believe it should be addressed responsibly. And one thing, I remember doing one of the engagements we had in my workplace, and one of the things that I'd raised was that it seems like there's a particular sect that seem to have their voice louder than everyone else's, and it seems like they are driving us to make decisions out of fear, and I'm not comfortable with that. However, they will continue to have how do I say it? They will continue to have be able to do that unless people that are reasonable, that are able to look at the issue dispassionately, step into the space as well. Understand the issues, weed out, sieve out what is propaganda and what is real, and address the real issues. Otherwise, we are all going to be pushed by people that probably have an agenda. But I believe that there's a real issue of climate change that needs to be addressed. We need to really talk about sustainability. We need to make sure that we are not driven by those that have an agenda, but we still need to address the issue. So for me, I want to step up and do what I can to be one of the sane voices, or let's say the John the Baptist that is crying in the wilderness saying, "Prepare ye a way for the Lord." So that's kind of what I'm looking at doing with this podcast as well. So I really will be focusing a bit more on what you can do as a person, but I'll definitely be touching it up with what people can do professionally, particularly for those that have roles to play professionally in helping us live sustainably. I think that's the word. So let me go into the gist part. I guess that's the one that gist seems to be one of my strengths. So sometime this past week, okay, we're still in the week. Today is Saturday. Sometimes this week, I got a video from one of my